Have you completed 40 days after your delivery? Shreya, why 40 days? If it's a cesarean section, it takes at least 40 days for you to have internal healing of all the basic muscles. And if it's a normal delivery, yes, within 20 days, probably you can resume these exercises. I've been telling almost in each video, the target is not weight loss. After delivery, first target is to experience strengthening, then toning, and then weight loss. So this particular video is for those who wish to feel strong at their body. Always remember, before joining Zumba or aerobics or gym or anywhere, this basic strengthening must be done by you. Start gradually with 2 to 4 repetitions and then slowly increase. Let's learn all the exercises which are basically for your core strengthening and which are going to help you all a lot. So first exercise. I've kept both the legs folding, both the hands on your knees. Just go back and hands on sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Yes, there's a little demand on the stomach. If it's just 40 days for your cesarean delivery, please don't feel stitches are going to be open, stitches will go, you'll do damage to the stitches, nothing will happen. So this is basically core strengthening exercise. Before starting all of those exercises, basic warm-up is needed. So if possible, just do a little jog, probably for 2 to 5 minutes, or fast walking for 2 to 5 minutes, and then you can get started. Bring the second repetition back and side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Remember, you're doing exercises after a very long time, so body is going to show bit of trembling, bit of shivering. That's absolutely normal. So once again, back, side. If you're very comfortable with this, lift your both the legs up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. See, the first one that I showed is plain. If you're very comfortable with this, you shift to the second version. That's just back, sides and legs lifted. If you're very comfortable with this one, you can shift to the third version of it. So hands on sides, go back, sides and just straight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. If you realize I'm having little shivering while doing this particular strengthening exercise, yes, I'm also working on it. So there's a third stage. Depending on your own fitness, you can go on progressing. The second exercise, which is very good for core strengthening, is Manjarasana. You straight your right leg. So if you have never done exercises before in your life, just do it with leg. So right leg up, count to 1 to 10 and relax. Left leg up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and relax. Once you're very comfortable with, might be at first go itself you'll be very comfortable with this, or might be you feel initially I was shivering and after 5 to 6 days down the line I feel better. That means your muscles are becoming a little more stronger with every repetition. If it's very comfortable for you, you shift to the second version. So other hand, so right leg and left hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Left leg, right hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. If you are very comfortable even with the second version, you can shift to the higher version with the hand and the knee and head. 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. See mamas, I'm showing you workout with every exercises at least 3 higher variations. So always remember, strengthening is not one thing that you do one exercises and you keep doing it and you're going to get your core stronger. So you do basic first stage for across 1 week or 2 weeks, depending on how your body respond. Then you shift to the higher stage for 1 to 2 weeks, and then you shift on the third stage for next 1 to 2 weeks. So across around 6 weeks down the line, you will realize that your core is really strong. You're not having a lot of back pain. You feel firm at your belly. It's not a weight loss exercises. They are strengthening exercises, which should be your first focus when you think about doing weight loss. The next exercise. This again works brilliantly well on core strengthening. This is your right posture in Vajrasana. You damage your posture by taking your knees slightly ahead and you change this angle. So right posture is where there is a 90 degree angle between your stomach and your knees. You change your posture, in fact make it wrong, knees slightly shifted ahead. Press both the toes on the floor and lift your knees up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, release. Once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, release. Once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and release. This is again an exercise which helps your core to be stronger. Next exercise. See, I'm not showing you too many exercises. I'm just showing you a few of the basics. Because you're starting after a very long time, let's learn next exercise. Lie down. And we're going to do floor cycling. So, first step, both the legs should be up. Hands on side. You take your right knee closer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Always remember, slower you do, better it is for strengthening. And because you are doing it after your delivery, it's always better that you be gentle on your body. Once again, I'm showing, if you're very comfortable with the slow version that I've shown, probably here you do 4 to 5 repetitions of each leg. So total probably 10 to 12, depending on your comfortable to start with. Once you're very comfortable with the slow version of the whole thing, you can shift to a faster 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Once you get comfortable even with this, you go for cross. You hold your ear, goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here I go, right elbow, left knee, left elbow, right knee. Another leg should be straight. And this goes brilliantly well, especially to work on your core strengthening. There's one wonderful line that my teacher have taught me very early in life. You are as much strong as much your core muscles are. So let's take care of your core muscles. If any one of you feels, my child is now big, like 10 year, 8 year, 5 year, and I've never worked on my core. Even for you, these exercises can do wonders. Okay, let's learn next core strengthening exercises. Hands on sides and legs shoulder width apart, knees shoulder width apart, and lift your hips up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This will work brilliantly well to recover your back pain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All those of you who have just delivered and seen this video, there's another video on my Twija YouTube channel which says exercises to be started right after delivery. Please do that for first 40 days in case of C-section, for first 20 days in case of normal delivery, and then you can start with these exercises. Relax. If you're very comfortable with doing this for 1 or 2 weeks, then you shift to the second version of it, up and right leg in front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and closer. Remember the sequence. Hips up, left leg up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 4, and release. Once again, up, right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, release. Left, up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and release. Once you become very comfortable with this, shift to the third version. Up, leg up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So 10 count becomes 1 repetition. Like that, you need to do 5 each. Remember, this is a third stage. So be gentle on your body, progress slowly. Then left up, hips up, left leg up, and you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Relax. Remember, you must have a lot of water. Keep your body hydrated, otherwise you might go through crampings once you start with your strengthening exercises. Next is a wonderful exercise for core strengthening. You just sit, both the legs are folded, legs go a little straight, upper leg is in front, and you lift your body. Initially, you can just keep your hand down and balance 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. If you will notice, I am very comfortable with this. You lift and release the support. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you are very comfortable with releasing the support, you can think about doing the third exercise, which is you lift up and it goes 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And that's a demanding exercise. So once you do this, it takes care of your side core as well. Let me show you on the other side. Folded legs slightly straight. Upper leg must be in front, hands on side. First stage, you lift, hands down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you're comfortable with this, you shift to the second stage. Remember, when you can say I'm comfortable with this, when you're able to do 5-5 repetitions without feeling any kind of a discomfort or pain. You lift and up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. If you become comfortable with this, you shift to the third version. 1. 2, 3, 4 and 5. See the slight shivering that even I am feeling. So I am actually practicing currently all these third stage core strengthening exercises to make my core stronger. And I don't feel any bad when I'm showing in front of a video and I'm able to show you all. See, if you see all of the exercises, I'm very comfortable till the second stage of core strengthening. Third stage, I'm definitely working. Let's work together. Now, next core strengthening exercise, you lie down on your stomach. It's called as forearm plank. Both the elbows and sides, fist, foot down, and you lift your body in straight line. Okay, first of all, if any one of you have got heavy hips, heavy stomach, and you're not able to lift up, then you need to press your knees on the floor and lift your upper body. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This becomes the first stage. The second one is version of only first stage. This I've just told for them who cannot do it. Actually, first stage is this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So lift your body straight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. If you're very comfortable with this, you shift to the stage 2 where you lift your right leg up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and down. Again you lift it, you'll be lifting your left leg up. Up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and down. Once you're very comfortable with this, you'll shift to stage 3. So you lift it up and it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and down. Yes, this is one exercise where I'm already doing stage 3 core strengthening very comfortably. So this works brilliantly well. And after this, make sure that you stretch your body. One of the basic stretching that you must be doing is you sleep. Both the hands up. You stretch your toes down. Stretch your hands up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And release. Once again, you stretch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And release. So once you have done with this two to four counts of the stretch that you are doing, you will be feeling comfortable. Now all of you, if you got time and your little one is allowing you to do, last to end all these exercises, you must be doing Surya Namaskar. Any thought, any school of thought that you have been following when it comes to Surya Namaskar, all are right. Currently, I'm just showing you one of the type of Surya Namaskar. One of the Surya Namaskar that I'm showing you all is a sitting Surya Namaskar. To get started with, you can even think about to get started with standing Surya Namaskar. So many girls tell me, oh, in Surya Namaskar, can I lie down on my stomach? It's absolutely allowed. Just observe sitting Surya Namaskar. It's 1, it's 2, 3, 4. Again, a core strengthening exercise. 5. 6, 7 and 8. That's one of the type of Surya Namaskar that can make you feel very comfortable. So many girls are asking, Shreya, when can I start it with dieting? When you're breastfeeding your kid, please don't get into the diet part of it. You should eat healthy, you should eat balanced nutrition or balanced nutritive diet. You should have 2 fruits every day. You should have more than 3 liters of water. See to that you don't consume unnecessary ghee, fats, oil. It's not needed. It's just going to increase fat percentage in your body. It doesn't have any positive effect on your breast milk flow. Take care of those things which are going to help you to improve your breast milk flow, like garden cress seeds, 2 drops of lime juice, flax seeds, ajwain. So basically avoid unnecessary fat intake, unnecessary rice intake, and just take care of your diet. Once your baby is 5 months complete and baby is into 6 months, you can think about starting with top solid food. That ideally we say 6 months onwards, the top food or the solids must be introduced to the child. Till that time, keep your baby on exclusively breastfeeding, and within this phase itself, on an average, for you to reach stage 3 of every exercise, it will take 6 to 7 weeks. And once you have done with this 7 weeks of core strengthening, you can think about joining any of the fitness classes around you. Those who stay close to my place, you can join with me, you can join Zumba, you can join aerobics, you can join gym, you can join yoga. Whatever is that one thing which makes you feel very comfortable. Be regular on fitness. There are no shortcuts to it. All of you mamas over there, I am very happy to be able to work on my fitness. As my both the mothers says, like my mother-in-law and mama, we came to know importance for our fitness very late in life. So today we take a lot of medicines because of knee pain, back pain. At least your generation must start focusing on the fitness very early in life. All of you out there, please get started on your core strengthening. I repeat, normal delivery after 20 days, get started. Cesarean section after 40 days, get started. Before getting started, do talk to your doctor once and ask, can I get started with exercises? Yes, gently, but consistently. Thank you so much, all of you. Have a great time and bye.